mentioned that you had to, because you play an older character, you have to have etiquette. You have to have sort of with someone of your age. And did you, you took etiquette classes? Is this?
Yeah, I thought it was time. I mean, I just like laid upon your desk when I arrived, so you can tell
we
that
noticed.
Like, I don't
it
really
will.
Have my act together. Yeah. but I'm working on it. I went to dinner once with Anna Wintour and Karl Lagerfeld, which is just like, I'm sitting
That's
there
terrifying.
Thinking like, who invited me here? And you know, I'm ordering like the scones with the bacon and the cheese and the butter and like getting it on my elbows
here,
and my toes. And like,
where you at?
The Ritz in Paris.
Oh, wow.
Like,
where, gotcha.
Oh, that was loud. Yeah. but, like where Coco Chanel lived and ate. And I didn't know what for. I was Jack Dawson in Titanic, and I just wanted to pass someone a note
gotcha.
By a clock because I did not belong there and go
they
down to the Irish
to
people and spin
yeah.
and like, you know, there were no Irish people around. It was like really, it was really mortifying. So I thought I can't be in this. I can't have this experience.
And is your
again.
Etiquette better now, do you think?
No.
That's all right. That's okay. At least you tried. It's all
right. Yeah, I eat pretty poorly, and my husband says the reason that I don't gain as much weight as I should is because only 10% of it makes it into my mouth.
it's just around the surrounding
no, it's
areas.
No, like, it's like I don't even know where the food goes, but
well,
it's
all right.
It's like I'm in a food fight with myself
at
every moment.
You also had a dinner with President Obama, a very small dinner.
I sound so cool.
Yeah, this is really cool.
It's like, I don't leave the house.
Except that moment where you had to be on the tiny pony. Your life's pretty awesome.
Yes, you didn't make me.
But you, so you got, and this was a small enough dinner party that everybody got a chance to sort of say hello to the president.
Yeah, I was like, all these world leaders, and I had no idea how I was invited to that dinner.
Your face was covered in food.
Totally. Yeah.
They just told you we don't have scones and bacon. Yeah. You were throwing
a fit. Hens, give me a hen. They didn't know what it was.
Right.
Anyway, so I met Obama, and I had my whole speech planned, and he was introducing himself to everyone, and they were talking about the way that they were going to change the world, and he came to me, and I just was like, hope. This is like me summoning hope for myself. It was awful. The only thing I could think of was that he had left my husband a voicemail when he was running for president. And so I said, you left my husband a voicemail. And he was like, cool.
Oh, yeah. That's hard.
And he deleted it. It was just like, why did I say that? Like, what does it get? And then just like, it got worse. And I was like, he deleted it because you were just a senator then. and then I was like, that was bad. So I was like, well, he didn't know you would be president. I mean, who thought that you would be president? Can you leave my husband a voicemail? Like, I just was like, it was just getting worse. And they confiscated our phones beforehand. And he said, well, give me your phone. I said, I can't. You took it. He said, well, ask for it back. I said, you're the president. You asked for it back. So then he starts shouting across the table, someone get Blake's phone. And then all these other people are sitting there thinking, like, what is this, like, gossip squirrel doing? Like, asking for her cell phone.
Can't she make needs it to, like, through a dinner
yeah,
without a
phone.
Yeah, she's
gonna, like, live tweet and take selfies. And then I was so embarrassed, and people were like, you asking for your phone? You're not allowed to do that. But anyway, he ended up leaving my husband an incredibly funny and ball-busting email, voicemail. But then I didn't get to take the picture with him shaking his hand and talking about the change we're going to make in the world because I was just like dying.
Right.
And but my picture instead is while he's leaving my husband the voicemail and he hands the phone back. And I'm looking at the voicemail, but instead the photo, I'm just looking at my phone like this, and he's like saying something to me, which is like, I can't wait to share it with my kids. So Obama's like trying to talk to me. I'm like,
it's so
22 likes.
So weird. You thought you needed etiquette class.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, now you see why I was a little insecure.
And you have a baby now as well. Yes,
I do.
Congratulations.
Yes, I think yes, I have a baby. Thank you.
Well, based on everything I know about you, she's going to grow up to be she's going to eat well, she's going to behave well, she's going to be incredibly, she's going to know how to shake the president's hand.
Yeah, she's, oh boy, that poor child.
Yeah.
We got to delete this. Can you delete things
that
are on
delete.
The internet
yeah,
and the world wide web?
You can take care of it. I think we're a few years away, but I wouldn't worry about her. And thank you so much for being here. It's
thank
lovely
you.
To see you.
Thank you for having
Blake Lively, everybody. The Adriana Line opens everywhere this Friday.